Life and death, brain and body. The human experience is entirely guided between these parameters as we all build our everyday realities on Earth. But overshadowing everything we ever achieve, the seeming nothingness of death beyond has long played on our minds. For thousands of years, human beings have sought to understand dying. And in the last couple of centuries or so, science has stepped in to try its hand at the problem. And now it's made another major step forward. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, did scientists just discover that your brain lives after you die? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. Let's start with one of the greatest questions of all. What actually is life? It can be understood in a purely physical way, of course, through the steady beating of a working heart, or by the constant rhythms of breathing, growth, energy, and biochemistry. From the bend of a stem toward the sun, to the springtime rituals of mating birds, to the steady covering of moss over an ancient rock face, these are signs of living organic materials all around us. The question of consciousness, though, never fails to cloud the issue. Why do we think and feel? How does the human experience differ from any other animals? Indeed, does it differ at all? And sooner rather than later, we end up at the brain, the body's most intricate organ, and an ongoing enigma for researchers. The human brain in particular has before been variously described as the single most complex structure not just within us, but within the entire universe. Whether or not it's true, it's certainly the case that even now, after centuries of dedicated study, there's still so much more that we don't know about it than do. A vast and tangled mosaic of firing neurons and delicate connections, many argue that consciousness is solely a product of the brain. We know that we're alive thanks to the brain, but the idea is that we also only know that we're alive thanks to the brain as well. As such, and if there's even a suggestion that life as we understand it is held in the brain, then it's little wonder that humans are so interested in what happens here when we die. In May 2023, details emerged of a multi-authored study at the University of Michigan. The accompanying paper, published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Science, ran with a complex title which read, Surge of Neurophysiological Coupling and Connectivity of Gamma Oscillations in the Dying Human Brain. The same paper gets more directly to the point within its opening gambit, however, cutting through the jargon to ask, quote, is it possible for the human brain to be activated by the dying process? The study suggests that although there is a general assumption that brain activity decreases during death, especially during cardiac arrest, findings show that actually the opposite could be happening. That instead, at the time of death, the brain might encounter a sudden surge of energy. There had been indications towards this during some past experiments conducted on animals, but comparative data from humans is typically very difficult to obtain, given the ethics involved in studying death rather than trying to prevent it. Nevertheless, the University of Michigan team presents data relating to 4 patients, all of whom were in a comatose state before all of them did sadly die. In all cases, with their family's permission, the patients were taken off life support when it was deemed that they could not be saved. At this point, though, specialists analyzed their brains in detail and from various perspectives. The main and potentially major finding was that in 2 of the 4 dying brains, there was a clear surge of gamma wave activity, a high-energy jolt that seemingly sparked up in certain key areas. Again, while the question of consciousness is still far from answered, scientists do believe that there could be certain parts of the brain that are more involved in producing it than others. And, in a further supporting article for the study, published on the University of Michigan website, lead research communicator Kelly Malcolm explains how the gamma injection was witnessed around those areas that are crucial for consciousness. Malcolm refers to a, quote, so-called hot zone, the junction between the temporal, parietal, and occipital lobes in the back of the brain. According to Malcolm, this area, a point that was lit up in 2 of the 4 dying brains, is otherwise linked with, quote, dreaming, visual hallucinations in epilepsy, and altered states of consciousness in other brain studies, end quote. So could these findings imply that some kind of alternate consciousness experience is had upon death? Going one step further, does the brain live after you die? Kelly Malcolm writes that the team behind the study urges caution when applying the results to any potential wider truth. It's also the case, writes Malcolm, that it was impossible to know in this study what the patients themselves experienced because they did not survive to relay that information back. Certainly, beyond the gamma wave surge, there's no indication that the patient's brains displayed anything other than the usual expected signs of having died, of having ceased to function forever. What's more, in the paper to accompany the study, the team notes that, quote, although the marked activation of the posterior hot zone in the dying brain is suggestive of elevated conscious processing, it does not demonstrate it, end quote. That is, although heightened consciousness appears to have happened in these two cases, we do not yet have proof that that really is what happens, neither here nor for humankind as a whole. Nevertheless, towards the paper's close, the tone is confident. Empirical evidence present in this study, writes the team, strongly suggests that the dying human brain can be activated. So what's your verdict? Should this latest data change how we view death? Is there a chance that actually dying doesn't represent the end of consciousness? Or is a surge in brain activity at the end of our lives to be expected? After all, in terms of trauma, there can be no single moment that would register more than the very end of life. In fact, many argue along these lines in order to explain near-death experiences, too. Studies suggest, for example, that during a near-death experience, the parts of the brain tasked with memory recall are suddenly and particularly hard at work. It's then proposed that that's why we've come to know and expect the ethereal sensation of having our lives flash before our eyes. Again, it's thought that this could be linked to the trauma of that moment, as the dying brain mounts a last-ditch attempt to try and make sense of the situation. Perhaps the gamma wave surges recorded during the May 2023 study are indicative of a similar process in action. It's just that in this case, the brains hosting the activity did, unfortunately, pass on shortly after. Of course, away from science, and over many thousands of years until now, there have been various other explanations offered up as to what happens after we die. Many of the world's leading religions are built on and around stories of an afterlife, seemingly to provide comfort for those trying to contemplate the incomprehensible. If nothing else, then this latest study does at least give another insight into what really happens, physically speaking, when the human body gives out. As incredible as our bodies are, they do perish. Death is a fact of life, and it will remain that way until we discover a genuine route toward immortality. Perhaps these most recent insights into the very last moments of the brain will even help toward that, one day providing the basis for a technology to keep us going. For now, studies such as these provide thought-provoking insights into some of our most profound existential questions. What is life? Is there something more? Does any part of us survive after we're gone? We don't yet have the answers, but we are continuing to probe for them. And research into the mind, body, consciousness, and the soul is always gathering pace. Did scientists just discover that your brain lives after you die? Not exactly. But with this one small sample of dying brains, science has hinted that in 2 out of the 4 brains studied, there was something taking place. One final surge of energy right at the close. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.